So tell me why. Tell me why. You ain't moving. Why?
Test. Ah, shut up, Pane, mate, they won't believe it. Your lies were pitiful on the original. Nobody's having that on the remix. Fair enough, bruv, same rules apply.
MiKill Pane is the guy that Justin Smith has undercreated as an arch nemesis for Smythe, who was his old alter ego. Smythe is now dead. Long live MiKill Pane.
Yeah, just I think the main difference is just MiKill Pane's very outspoken and doesn't really sort of bite his tongue for anyone.
I'm not too sure, man. I can't pinpoint it. Without sounding cliche, I just do me, innit? Obviously, no one else is me. So, I've got an advantage in that sense. Do you know what I mean? People can always copy everyone else. You know, there's a lot of Jay-Z wannabes. There's a lot of Kanye West wannabes. And I think that, like, maybe there is someone who I am like, but because they're not at the forefront of the industry, I'm getting away with it, innit? Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm nothing like Jay-Z, I'm nothing like Kanye West. And they're probably the two biggest MCs at the moment. Obviously with people like Drake and J. Cole and that, but I'm nothing like them either. So there must be someone bubbling on the surface that everyone's forgotten about that I'm like, maybe, perhaps. Because nothing's original really. So yeah, I think I'm just flagging it at the moment.
A Negro boy takes steps towards a white man, looks him in the eye and extends his right hand. The Caucasian holds the black guy's gaze while he calmly says, get out of my way. The black boy doesn't want to show, he's so scared that he could wet himself, so he says, I'm going nowhere. The white man barges the black boy so hard he staggers across the room and falls back on the sofa. The black boy's eyes fill with tears of rage, but they're wiped away before they go near his face by a white hand. The owner screams, you're letting, that's enough. The voice belongs to the girl that he loves, and she loves him too, so she wants to protect him. She spent months trying to get her pops to accept him, but the white man seems stuck in his ways. The Negro boy gets up and exclaims,
you don't know me, how can you be so against me, so unfriendly, tell me what I've done. If you,
I guess tests never really matter, I guess tests never really matter, I guess tests never really matter.
That song is basically almost like a conversation between like sort of skeptical rude boys that are really into like the gangster mentality that modern hip hop has instilled, and me. So like I'm saying, look, I don't care what you think. I know you probably don't want me here, but I couldn't care less. I'm not doing this music for anyone but myself. People just happen to like it, and if you don't, fair enough. And then from their perspective, they're saying, well, like that stuff you're doing is not going to fly with anyone, because right about now it's all gone. It's all gone this way. It's all gone like a really sort of gangster way. And it's kind of true, to be fair, man. Like, the more sort of braggadocious and macho you are, and then the more you boast about sort of negative exploits, sometimes it seems the further you get. Strange things happen when you go down there. People bring them to my attention, man. Like, obviously, I get a lot of comparisons with Ghost Poet. I think we both have beards and we're both black and we both have glasses. I think it's one of those things, like, but people say Mike Skinner quite a lot from the streets. Those are the two main ones these days, Ghost Poet and Mike Skinner. I got Slick Rick once and super duper happy, man. I actually don't. When I first started, it's a lot of fun for me. I actually find it quite fun, and I think that's important. I think too many people put their business hats on all day. Don't put your business hat on all day, man. Like, there's a time and a place, and I think if you're doing what you love, first and foremost, and then you realise that people like it, that's when the business side comes in.
His daughter tells him he's an awful coward and says she'd be a lot better off without him. The white man spins around, eyes all wild, and says to his daughter, "You're my only child. You know what I'm about, you could have done the right thing, but no, you had to go and drag whole scum like him. I won't be here to guide you forever, but I'm telling you before it's too late that you should try and do better. All my friends have said I've lost my mind and I've had enough. They know my princess is with a guy of his caliber, and sometimes I try to ignore him, but get an uncontrollable urge to knock his lights out and floor him. I can't believe he took my princess from me, so I don't feel guilty when he says to me,
'You don't know me. How can you be so against me, so unfriendly? Tell me what I've done. If you've got issues, then just say so. You don't know me.'" The one you
never suspected was actually a rapper. Willpower, who's been my DJ for a while and my producer. I used to work for a brand called All Saints, and as I was getting a promotion, quite a short-lived promotion because I got made redundant shortly after, but as I was getting a promotion, Will was working on the shop floor because he was a student, so he was working part-time, and we just started talking about music, and he was just like, "Oh yeah, come listen to some of my beats, we'll have a little smoke and just like chat about music and that." So yeah, literally from then, that was when the relationship was formed. Like, he started being my main producer, then he became my DJ. So him out one as Labyrinth's brother. It's actually a good look. A few others as well, man. I've got a really shit memory. So it's no disrespect, but yeah, there are a few others. My old DJ, my ex-DJ, Odin, he was good mates with Hudson Mohawk when Hudson Mohawk went by another name, actually. But I can't remember what that name was. But yeah, I've heard his stuff is sick. Hudson Mohawk is gone, like, production wise, he's gone. Yeah, hell yeah, that'd be sick. That's a hard one. I can't choose one. Oh Jesus. Jay-Z, Annie Lennox, Alex Turner from the Arctic Monkeys. Yeah, Bad Brains would be sick to work with. Yeah, Mumford and Sons. I'd really like to work with Mumford and Sons. Respect, I reckon. Respect followed by money. Very closely followed by money. Yeah, because you gotta live, man.
Beautiful family. The white man looks the black boy in the eye and says everything he said was pointless. Why? It's not because you're black that I don't want you near my daughter. It's because you're an Arsenal fan. I'm a Tottenham supporter.
You don't know me. How can you be so against me, so unfriendly? Tell me what I've done. If you've got issues, then just say so. You don't know me. I'm only asking you to accept me and respect me. Give me just one chance. I've got too much to lose to let you.
Massive big up, peace out to UK Chocolate, and you're watching UKCTV.